Good morning. I'm Tim Archer, and we are reading through the New Testament. I have a website, timothyarcher.com, if you want to go there to see the readings, or you can just follow along here. That's okay. Today we're reading 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 1 through chapter 11, verse 15. So it's 10, 1 through 11, 15. Paul is talking about some false teachers. He calls them super apostles. That may be what they called themselves. They had come into Corinth after Paul and were wanting to change everything he taught. And to do it, they were attacking him, right? Because they had to get his credibility out of the way. And so he spends some time defending himself, but especially reminding them that the truth doesn't depend on people, you know? And at the end, he says, even Satan can disguise himself as an angel of light. And we need to remember that. We can't build our faith around personalities. We can't base our beliefs on what this person told me or that person told me or what dad always thought or what the preacher says or what this guy on the internet told me. We need to read God's Word. We need to read the Bible. We need to try and understand it. I'm not saying that we just open it and read it and not think about context in those things. We need to read intelligently, right, and learn to read well. But we need to base our beliefs on what God has said and not what people tell us, because you can't always spot the wolf in sheep's clothing. To do so, you have to look at the results of their teaching. You have to see if they're proclaiming, you know, prosperity instead of Jesus, if they're teaching, you know, healing more than holiness, if they're leading you away from a godly life and a life of justice, and especially if they're preaching something besides Jesus, right? We don't follow men. We don't follow some group. We don't follow anything of this world. We follow the risen Lamb. Pray with me. Our Father and God, today we ask that you speak to us through your Word and that you give us a hunger and thirst for knowing you through your Word. Not just knowing about the Bible, but knowing you and learning how you are and how you want us to be by reading your Word. We pray that you help us to understand. We also pray for discernment, to be able to spot those who would lead us astray. And Father, we pray today that we may be faithful servants of yours. We pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. I hope you have a blessed Saturday.